Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the Wall Street Mojo channel. To know more about this video, NPV in Excel, watch the video till the end. And if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below. I welcome all of you. Today we have a topic, NPV, which is a financial function used in capital budgeting. Most of the time, let's understand this topic in a detailed format. As you can see, there is an NPV function, but before that, we need to understand some of the nitty-gritty of this function. Now, NPV in Excel is also known as the net present value in Excel, which is used to calculate the difference of the PV of cash inflow minus PV of cash outflow, okay, as an input. Now, NPV in Excel, how does it work? See, the NPV function on Excel calculates the net present value for a periodic cash flow based on the supplied discount. Okay. Now, NPV in Excel is generally leveraged under the financial calculation. Well, in financial projections, the NPV in Excel is useful to in finding the values of an investment or analyzing the feasibility of the project. And it is also recommended that it is better for the financial analyst to use the XNPV function. Okay, that is the NPV function in Excel. Okay, now how does this NPV formula work? So you will say is equal to NPV. Then we have values. So the NPV in Excel accepts the arguments like rate, value 1 and value 2. So the rate is the discount rate over the length of the period. Value 1 and value 2. Value 1 is required. They are the numerical value that represents a series of the payment and income where outgoing payments are mentioned as negative numbers and the incoming payments are mentioned as a positive number. So what is the NPV equation that will go about? The calculation of the NPV of an investment in an Excel NPV function is based upon the equation as the values divided by 1 plus rate raised to the number of years. So how to use this formula? Very important question. How to use the NPV formula in Excel? Well, let's take a few NPV Excel calculation examples before using NPV function in Excel workbook. Suppose that we are, let's say, working on the following data and on cash flows, outflow and inflow. Below is a spreadsheet that shows a simple example of the NPV function in Excel. The rate argument that is supplied to the function is stored in a cell C11. And the value of the argument have been stored in C5 to C9, all of these ones. Okay, and the NPV in the Excel is entered in C13, right? The function gives the result over here based on what we write: NPV, the rate, the values, close the bracket. So it gives 231.63. Now note that in this example, the initial investment of $500, which is shown in C5, was done at the end of the first period. And that is why this value is considered as the first argument, that is value 1 to the NPV function in Excel. Now the NPV formula in Excel example number 2, see the above spreadsheet, okay, shows a further example in which the first payment is made at the start of the first period and how this payment should be considered in the NPV function Excel. So again, the rate of 10% is stored in C11 and the cash flow value argument of the transaction is stored in between the range of C5 to C9. Again, the rate is stored at 10% here and the transaction values are given with the initial investment. So we will write something like this. So we So now here, if the initial investment is 500, which is shown in C5 here, and was done at the start of the first period, and this value is not included in the argument to the NPV function in Excel. Instead, the first cash flow is added to the NPV Excel results. So as described in example number 2, the net present value is established on the future cash flows. And if the first cash flow happens at the start of the first period, the first cash flow value must be added to the NPV Excel result. And it should not be included in the value argument. Now, what are some of the things that you should remember while dealing with this kind of formulas? First, the NPV investment begins one period ahead of the date of the value 1 cash flow, and it ends with the last cash flow in the list. So the NPV calculation in Excel is based upon the future cash flows. You know, if the first cash flow is made at the beginning of the first period, the first value must be explicitly added to the NPV Excel result, and it should be excluded in the value arguments. Like, for example, you know, what we have seen, the above ones. Now, let's say that in the number of the cash flows in the list of the values, the formula for the NPV will be value divided by 1 plus R, okay, and that will be raised to T, okay. So if the arguments are supplied individually, the number, logical values, blank cells, and the text representation of the numbers, they are evaluated as the numerical value, while the others of the cell in the text are error and are ignored from the function. Now, if the arguments are supplied in the what we call as the range, okay, all the numerical value, I'm saying all the numerical values in the range are ignored specifically, okay. So we need to enter the transaction payments and income values in a right sequence as the NPV function used the order of the second argument, that is value 1, 2, to evaluate the order of the cash flow. And the key difference between the NPV function and the PV function is that the PV allows the cash flows to begin with either at the beginning or at the end of the period. And the NPV function is basically a latest version, okay? It is the latest version of the Excel. And it can be accepted with as many as 254 value arguments, basically. But with Excel 2003, only up to 29 values can be supplied by this function. So that's it for this particular video. If you learned watching this video, then don't forget to like, comment on this video, and subscribe us for all the latest updates. Thank you, everyone, once again.